Hey guys, Troy from Gold Coast Prints here, here to walk you through another printing and photography tutorial. Let's get started. So today we're going to be exporting an image for print. Just want to go ahead and open up Photoshop. We're going to go up the top to File, Open. I'm going to get this image straight off my SD card from the camera. Here's my image. I'm happy with it. I don't need to edit this at all. I'm going to go up the top to Image, down, click on Image Size, and then in this box that pops up, I'd like to print it at 20 by 30 inches, so obviously making sure that it's on inches here in the drop-down boxes, inches, and then for the height, I'm going to change that to 20, width 30. Also make sure this is ticked here, the Constrain tool. These lines indicating that the dimensions are linked together, so when you do change the height, it's also going to change your width up the top. So 20 by 30 inches natively, the resolution straight off the camera has come at 350 pixels per inch. You want to make sure that this is at least 300 ppi for printing. A common mistake people make in Lightroom is the default settings in Lightroom generally save an image to a resolution of 72. This is way too low and it's going to come out poorly. But if you are using Lightroom, make sure that you're saving the image to its maximum JPEG quality and that your resolution or PPI is a minimum of 300. You can see that in the export settings in the image size when you go to export in Lightroom. But for this example today in Photoshop, the resolution 350, that's great. We are resampling the image, we're upsizing it to 20 by 30 inches from approximately 10 by 15 inches. So my favorite resample method is bicubic smoother. Just after hundreds and hundreds of prints, I just feel like this is definitely the best option for us here at Gold Coast Prints. So this is the one that I use. If you do have a really high megapixel camera and you are printing an incredibly large image, sometimes preserved details can be the slightly better option, keeping the reduced noise between sort of 5 and 10%. You don't want to go any further than that, otherwise you're just taking away the details that you're trying to preserve and it's just going to be a little bit soft. So I keep it around 5% if I'm going to do preserved details, but like I said, I prefer bicubic smoother, so I'm going to be doing that today. I'm going to click OK, and there it is. Go up the top to File, click on Save As, Save on Computer. I'm going to save this one to my desktop. Come down to the Save As Type, click JPEG. And I also always click Save As a Copy, because I like to have the original file on hand if I want to re-edit, or I've always got that high quality file saved as a backup, so any edits that I want to do or any new styles that I want to do with that image, I can go back and start from that high quality original file straight off the camera. If you save a JPEG and continue to save it and re-edit it and resave it, you will lose detail and it will just print poorly over time. So if you are going to re-edit a file, don't keep editing it and saving it as a JPEG, because you will lose detail. Always edit off your original file, and then when you're ready, save as a high quality JPEG, which we're going to do now. So click Save. Pops up with this box, JPEG options. You want to make sure that this slider is all the way to the right with a quality of 12, which is the maximum JPEG quality it can save as. We're going to make sure baseline is ticked, and we're going to click OK. So there you have it guys, that's exporting a file for print. Cheers for tuning in, hit the subscribe and like button, and we'll see you for the next tutorial. Yoo!